Off day between games 1 and 2 for the Philadelphia Flyers. A practice day at Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. An optional day for most of the players as they, again, try to conserve their energy. They've been doing this for quite some time here over the last couple of months, and they are pretty well in tune with what it takes to get ready for the next game. The Flyers, of course, did have that 2-0 loss to the Washington Capitals in game 1, but they feel like it was a pretty close game. They were just 1-0 down until the last few minutes of that contest, and they still feel like this team has an extra gear. They feel like they can improve a few things and come out for game 2 even stronger than they did for game 1.
It was a 1-0 game until, what, 4 minutes to go in the game. So no, we were right there. The thing is, we still feel like we go a whole lot better. Maybe our second or third period wasn't where we wanted to be, but we still feel like we got better and we can generate more offensively.
Just gotta keep it simple. I mean, Holby was good. You know, we had a couple of good looks. Him and Mace were outstanding yesterday. They were two best players on the ice, no doubt about that. And just, you know, get a traffic and get the pucks to the net. I mean, that's a play of hockey. Everything can go in.
Of course, the big question for the Flyers headed into game 2 is the status of Sean Couturier. The Flyers know that they've played without Couturier before, and they've been able to figure things out. And they've been doing that with other players throughout the lineup all year long.
Been itching to get back at it for sure. So, like I said, if I'm in, then I'm excited for the opportunity. And just going to try and help the team get a win. That's the biggest thing. Come in here and take one from them and go back home.
Well, I mean, there's a lot of ifs there. You know, number one, you know, if he's in, you switch from the winger position to the center position. Shenner's been able to do that for us throughout the year. So if we need to make that change, I know he'll be comfortable doing it. You know, he's very comfortable, in both of those spots. In fact, all three spots up front.
Of course, one of the things the Flyers will be looking at from game 1 is their power play. They went 0-for-3 in the first period on Thursday, and that was a situation that could have changed the tempo of the game had they gotten a goal there. The Flyers feel like things are going fairly well on the power play. They're getting the movement that they want, but they know that they've got to come up with a little bit of an extra gear to take on a Capitals penalty kill that was the fourth best in the league during the regular season.
When you look at the game yesterday, there wasn't much 5-on-5 win either way. So I think we did a very good job defensively yesterday, you know, all four lines, and we didn't give them much. So, I would say more about a power play. Power play needs to score. We had 3 opportunities in the first period. You know, if we score the goal, the game could be different. So I think that's what we got to look for.
I guess when you don't score goals, you could say you're struggling. But, I mean, I think our chances are there. I mean, our entries are really, really good. I mean, we're getting pucks to the net. It's they're not going in. I mean, we're just going to stick with it and just keep doing our thing.
Yeah, obviously we had 3 chances early to, you know, take control of that game and obviously didn't capitalize on it. And I think for us, we got to get those guys shooting at the top, and if they start shooting and maybe getting a few one-timers, hopefully things will start to open up. Maybe some lanes will open up, but that's something we're going to have to look at and then go from there.
So come Saturday night, game 2 here at Verizon Center in Washington, Flyers will be looking to tie the series at 1 game apiece. We'll have complete coverage of the game throughout the day on Saturday right here at PhiladelphiaFlyers.com.